Hey friends, welcome to KNACKK. In this tutorial, you will learn to draw the swirling strawberry candy shape. Like much of our other tutorials, this tutorial is also about experimenting with basic shapes. This time, we'll be working with ellipse. Transforming basic shapes can be way more fun than you think. Let me make you believe that. Let's start with our drawing. First things first, turn off this Align Art to Pixel Grid button and make sure that Smart Guides are on. Get the ellipse tool and click once on the artboard. Enter 300 for both width and height. Now pick the rotate tool. Press and hold Alt key and click once on this anchor point to make it the axis point. Here enter 20 degrees and press copy. Now select both these circles. Open the Pathfinder panel. If you don't have this panel here, you can get it from Window menu. Alright. Now with both these shapes selected, press this minus front button. We are left with this cutout shape. Keep it selected. Get the rotate tool once again. Press and hold Alt key and click once on this anchor point. Enter 20 degrees. And press copy. Okay, now we'll color these shapes. Select this shape and fill it with this strawberry color. Now select this shape and fill it with this light gray color. Nice. Okay, now we have to remove stroke from these shapes. Select both of them and remove their stroke. These shapes are still under selection. Make them a group. Alright. Get back to the rotate tool. Press and hold Alt key and click once at this anchor point. This time rotate it by 40 degrees and get a copy. Now to swirl it, you have to repeat this rotation for a few more times. So with this copy selected, come to Object menu, here Transform, and go for this Transform Again option, which simply repeats the last transform action, or you can simply press Ctrl D. So I'm hitting Ctrl D for 7 times. Perfect. Now you have this basic yummy candy shape ready. See its nice smooth and soft curves. Now this candy requires some working with glow and highlights to give it a somewhat realistic 3D look rather than just being a flat drawn shape. Select all these shapes and make them a group. Now create a duplicate of this group. Just press and hold Alt key and drag out a duplicate of it. Alright. Now I'm going to use this copy to create some highlighting stuff. Ungroup it twice to remove all the grouping inside this shape. Now come to Pathfinder panel and press this Unite button to make it a single shape. Look here at these traces of the shapes left within this united shape. We have to get rid of them. Keep them selected and hit the Unite button once again. Okay, it has reduced the traces, but we are not clear of them. No worries, we have another trick. Look here, this shape is a compound path. We have to release it first. Open the object menu. Here, compound path, and go for this release option. Now select just this path. Move it aside for a while. Now drag over this area to select all the residuals and delete them. Okay, now coming back to the shape, we have to give it a gradient fill. Open gradient panel, give the shape this default black and white gradient, change the gradient type to radial. Now here in color bar, select this white color, set its location at 50%, click once over this area to add a new color, drag it to the extreme left and change the color to black. Change its opacity to 10%. Select this black now and bring down its opacity to 10% as well. Now select this white color and change its opacity to 45%. Now with only this shape selected, open the transparency panel. Here set the blending mode to hard light. Alright, now select this shape, open effect menu, here stylize and go for outer glow. Here set the mode to screen. This black color will go fine for the glow. Keep the opacity at 75% and blur at 5 pixels. Alright, now select both these shapes. Come to align panel. If you don't have this panel here, you can get it from window menu. Okay, now here in align panel, make sure that align to artboard option is selected here. Now go for horizontal align center and vertical align center. Nice. Both these shapes are under selection right now. Make them a group. And it completes our drawing. Isn't it interesting how we drew just a single ellipse and transformed it into this sweet candy shape in just a few steps? I hope you have liked this tutorial. Don't forget to share your feedback in the comment section below. And if you have any queries with Adobe Illustrator, you may ask them here. We'll be glad to help you. That's all for now. Thank you very much for your time.